Each month on Smart Medicine, we give you the chance to ask the expert. This month's topic, MRSA, MRSA infections. Joining me now is Dr. Manoj Jain. And Dr. Jain, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me, Joe.
Tell us, what is MRSA, MRSA?
You know, MRSA stands for methicillin-resistant staph aureus. It's really a bacteria, like a staph infection. We've heard about staph infections happening on our skin and so forth. What MRSA is, it's a resistant form of that infection. And so it makes it very difficult for us to manage.
What types of treatment are there for people who present with this?
You know, the initial stages, we used to use penicillin and cephalosporins like Keflex. But MRSA cannot be treated by those antibiotics. We're having to use more and more powerful antibiotics, those that require intravenous forms, and those that can affect your kidneys and other forms, other organs in your body. So the problem with MRSA is that it can be treated, but it's very hard to treat.
And can it be prevented?
Yes, it definitely can be prevented. Just like other staph infections, what we encourage people to do is to wash their hands. And also, if you have a wound or any type of an infection, to cover that up. I'll tell you a story. I saw a hospital in North Carolina. They were able to reduce their staph infections in the hospital by half just by increasing their hand washing rate from 50% to 90%.
And so this is apparently the way it is spread from person to person.
Exactly. MRSA is spread by direct contact. So even in areas where, for example, it's contact sports, MRSA can be spread. So if any athlete has a wound, we encourage them to cover it up. It does not spread by air, so that's not a worry like influenza or other infections.
Well, thank you very much, Doctor, for being with us.
Okay, my pleasure.